Hi, I'm Wade from Thoroughbred Diesel, and today we are going to be installing BD Diesel's APPS noise isolator. BD's APPS noise isolator is a very, very good product for you guys that have automatic transmissions in your 1994 to 2005 Dodge trucks. Now, this is just a simple wire with a diode in it, and what this does, this actually cancels out or filters out the RF noise that is transferred through the APPS wire that feeds from on the VP trucks, feeding the signal from the ECM over to the PCM, and then the PCM that sends the signal out for your torque converter lockup. So what does this do for your truck? If you have a truck that has a problem with the torque converter cycling in and out, locking and unlocking, this could be a very good fix for you. Now, I want to be very, very clear in this video. If you have another electrical or mechanical issue going on with the truck, this is not going to fix your problem. If you have if you already have a transmission issue where you can't hold lockup, if you have an electrical issue, if your wiring harness on your truck is not in good shape, your grounds aren't good on your batteries, if you've got a wiring issue with your alternator or an alternator issue itself, this product, this will not fix this. Give you the example of how I'm putting this on. So shout out to my wife for letting us borrow her truck today for this. We are putting this on for a preventative thing. What I'm wanting a good crisp signal going to the torque converter lockup. I don't want any RF interference in the signal coming from the APPS sensor that is going to cause torque converter lock and unlock. So this is a preventative thing for this truck. If you've got that symptom in your truck, check your grounds, add this into the mix, it may fix your problem. But again, remember, if you've got big time electrical issues or you've got a mechanical issue inside the transmission, this is not going to fix your problem. So without further ado, let's get started with our installation of our BD APPS noise isolator. All right, before we start this job, I suggest that you remove your battery cables from your battery because you are working with a PCM connection here. So I like to take the air intake off. I've got a stock air intake on this truck, and not many of those left around there, but so we're gonna go ahead and just remove the intake here. Everybody knows how to do that. The wife, she's still got the original little plastic chintzy nuts in the bottom of here. So trying to leave this as stock as I can for this kind of stuff. Now that gives us access to the PCM itself. So put this cold air boot back in here real quick. There it is. All right, now on the PCM, we're gonna wanna be working with the C1 connector on the PCM. So the C1 connector is the one closest to your air dryer over here. So we're just gonna go ahead and push that connector down and unhook it. That, I feel like that gives me enough slack to be able to work with the harness here. You can go ahead and unhook the other two connectors if you want to. For the purpose of the video, we'll probably do this, but if you do another truck, you'll have plenty of room. So that gives you a real good look at what we're looking for here on the C1 connector. Now, for the 1996 to 2003 trucks, you're going to be looking for pin number 23. And if you look at these connectors, the connectors will all be numbered. But on this truck in particular, you're looking for the orange wire with a dark blue stripe. If you have any questions about that, BD inside of the kit here sends you instructions for your year, make, and model of what wire and what pin number that you will be looking for. So we are looking for pin number 23. Which is all the way to second one down here. which is orange wire with a dark blue stripe. There's only one orange wire here with a dark blue stripe, which is this one right there. All right, we're gonna go ahead and install our noise isolator here. So go ahead and open up our package, which is easier said than done. BD has been really doing well with some of their packaging. A lot of companies have right now. So your noise isolator is just a single wire here that will have a wire tap on it, and it will also contain the eyelet for the ground. And then there is a diode in here for the isolation of the RF signal. All right, so what we want to do here is, first thing that I want to do is I want to take the actual noise isolator assembly itself, and I want to go on the wire end of it, which would be the red cap here, and I just want to make sure that I've got wire protrusion here, that I've got some copper wire that is protruded through there, and it's making contact inside of this PosiTap cap here. I'm actually going to go one step farther here, and I'm going to use a little bit of dielectric grease inside of that side of the cap, just so I know that I've got a really good contact there. So we'll run that back up. Then I know that my wire side is going to be secure. Now, I'll take the tap side of that off, the cap, the black side. I'm going to go ahead and find my orange wire with a blue stripe again. And then I'm going to want to try on this, I want to try to aim this cap towards where I'm going with my ground wire. And the reason that is I don't want this, when it comes back to rest or when I go back to its position on the computer, I don't want it to have the wire in a bind. I want it to be at rest there, not pulling on itself. I'm going to go to this ground over here, which I'll show you in just a second. So that's pretty much the direction that I'm going to be going there. In fact, I'll fold it behind here. All right, on this end, same thing. I'm going to put just a little bit of dielectric grease down in the end of the pierce there, or in the piercing end here. I said a little, but I used a lot. The piercing end of this wire tap, this goes through and it actually pierces the wire, just like the name implies. It pierces the PCM wire to give you contact with the wire and the APPS signal wire. So we're going to go ahead and just screw that onto the PosiTap. And you want to make sure that your wire is spinning. Don't hook your ground up first in this. Don't hook your ground up first and then try to spin it, because again, that gets the wire in a pinch and we don't want to do that. So we just snug that down. We know that's made a good pierce there. We're in pretty good shape. So now to run our eyelet end over to the ground, or to our chassis ground. There's a ground on the PCM here, and I know that a lot of people use that. I'm not gonna ground back to the PCM, I don't wanna do that. What I'm gonna use is I'm gonna actually run this over to a body ground. There is a body ground coming from the negative wire off the battery. You just follow it over to this AC line underneath of there, and that ground is right there. So I'm gonna take my 5/16 here. I'm gonna go ahead and remove that sheet metal screw and this ground. If this ground needs cleaning, please do so at this time. Right now we just tighten this back down. All right. Now we've got our ground done. So what we're gonna do now is we're just gonna go ahead and we're gonna hook our computer connections back up here. If you undid all three, your white one goes in the middle. Be careful when you're doing this. Don't bend any pins. You bend a pin, you're gonna have some bad contact in here and it's gonna cause you lots of problems. So make sure that your connectors slide in freely. The C1 connector is the last one here. Push that in until it clicks. Then we will tuck our wire away. And that's got our APPS noise isolator for our Dodge truck installed. We're gonna go ahead and put our intake back on, put our batteries back on, drive the truck. If you had a torque converter cycling issue, I hope that this fixes your problem. If it does not, please continue to chase your wiring down. Make sure you check your battery cables, your alternator cables, make sure that there's no other grounding issues that you've got inside of the motor before you go attacking a mechanical issue with the transmission. So I'm Wade from Thoroughbred Diesel. Please like and subscribe to our channel. If you have a question about this installation or any of our other products or any of BD's products, please give us a call. Thanks for watching.